What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video, and today I'm reviewing Marvel Superhero Adventures Frostbite. So after ado, let's begin. This movie is a continuity with the Disney Marvel animated universe, and when watching this movie, I didn't realize it was technically a Christmas movie. And just like the rest of the Disney Marvel animated universe, this movie is awful. Pretty much ever since Ultimate Spider-Man started, this universe has been nothing but either mediocre at best or just straight up god-awful. And this movie is a prime example. This movie was bad. The writing was awful, the voice acting was awful, the character designs were awful, and the animation was cheap. It was overall a bad film. And this is probably the worst Marvel animated movie I've ever seen in my entire life. And it's part of the worst adaption of the Marvel Universe. The Disney Marvel Animated Universe. This is just as bad, if not a bit worse, than Infinite Crisis on Infinite Earth Part 1. While that movie was boring and badly written, this one is just cringeworthy and badly written. So the main plot of this movie, I kid you not, so Loki, of course, wants to take over the world, but he wants to absorb Mjolnir's powers. And who happens to be Mjolnir in this universe? Santa Claus. So Loki decides to go to Santa's hometown, not the North Pole for some reason, and pretty much absorb Santa Claus's powers, and he has this ice giant buddy with him. He pretty much wants to be above all gods, pretty much, and take over the world. Typical villain shenanigans. The fact they made Mjolnir Santa Claus is just pathetic to me and just hilarious. But I mean, I will give them credit because they had to fit Santa somewhere, because if Loki just kidnapped Santa Claus for the hell of it, it wouldn't fit at all. The only Santa Claus story where, you know, he is being kidnapped by a Marvel villain and it's up to a Marvel hero to save him is Deadpool. I mean, Deadpool. I don't see really anyone else unless Spider-Man is saving someone who, is dressed as Santa Claus, you know, a mall Santa. Other than that, I would only see Deadpool saving the real-life Santa Claus or any other Marvel obscure characters like Deadpool. But, you know, Deadpool's not appropriate for this universe, even though he appeared in one episode and was never mentioned again. Well, he was pretty annoying in this universe, so fair point. There are three plots that happen in this movie, and only two of them, only two of them really have something to do with one another. The third one is just filler to have the movie be an hour and 16 minutes. And believe it or not, the filler story is the best one, and that's with Rocket and Groot. Rocket and Groot are there for no reason. They pretty much want a new ship, well, mainly Rocket, and he sees his bounty on Santa Claus, and he's told that Santa Claus takes presents away from children. So, you know, he's trying to find Santa Claus along with his buddy Groot. He isn't part of the Guardians of the Galaxy at the time. I have no idea why these two are here to begin with. I guess it's to promote the Guardians of the Galaxy show that's in this universe, which is also very mid. But anyway, when they mistake Mrs. Claus for Santa Claus, they bring her to their ship because she was going really fast on her sleigh to find Santa, and because she believes that when Groot and Rocket were trying to kidnap her for the bounty, she thought they were pranking her. And yeah, she is very gullible. I mean, it's Mrs. Claus and, you know, fairy tales, holly and jolly. And when they're flying around in Groot and Rocket, when they're flying around in Rocket's ship, you know, Mrs. Claus tells them, the true meaning of Santa and who he really is. And, you know, Groot and Rocket start to have second doubts. And yeah, that's really it. And of course, they get their gift at the end of a new ship. That's really it. If you just remove that entirely, it wouldn't change anything. I think it was just to promote the Guardians of the Galaxy show. That's why they're in there. Too bad the Guardians were already established in this universe in the Ultimate Spider-Man cartoon. This universe is filled with bad continuity. And the art style got worse every season for Avengers Assemble, to where the last season wasn't even in continuity with the rest of the show. The Avengers in this universe are flat-out assholes or straight-up dumbasses. Believe it or not, the only Avenger I liked in this film was Captain Marvel. Yeah, Captain Marvel of all characters. You somehow made the big four of the Avengers unlikable. Thor is a dumbass who somehow has never heard of Santa Claus. Yeah, he's lived for a thousand of years, especially because Santa Claus in this universe is called Mjolnir, or that's his real name. Like, Thor has lived thousands of years, and he doesn't know who Mjolnir is. I honestly hate how this universe writes Hulk. Like, it feels like the way Hulk speaks in this universe, like, he just sounds way too smart to be just normal Hulk. And he's not smart Hulk yet. Like, he still has that angry side of the Hulk. Like, he talks back and stuff. Like, he's acting like, I don't know, a normal person in a way. I, you know, kind of like smart Hulk, but, like, at the same time, not like smart Hulk. You have to watch Hulk and the Agents of Smash or Avengers Assemble to understand what I mean, because I do not like how they portray Hulk in this universe at all. I feel like the writers just do not understand the Hulk whatsoever. Was it to give him more of a character? Because literally Earth's Mightiest Heroes just didn't even do this at all, and yet they made Hulk more likable. I just remembered there was one scene in the movie where they straight up go to Santa Claus's house, and I forgot his name, but he's the kid who could transform into a dinosaur, any dinosaur, and, you know, but it's always a red dinosaur. I forgot his name. I can't believe it. I know it starts with an R. I actually like him a lot. Not in this movie, though, because he's very annoying in this movie, and he still believes in Santa Claus. Well, I know Santa Claus is real in this universe, but for someone his age, like, he looks like he's in high school. And he's, like, just mad annoying. Like, I just want to punch him in the face. So anyway, when they're trying to find Santa, because they gotta make sure Loki doesn't get Santa Claus's powers. And actually, now I just remembered something else. So with the side story with Thor and Hulk, they pretty much find this guy named Nick, who looks like Santa Claus. And they dress him up as Santa. And they fly around a sleigh and deliver presents. So pretty much they're risking this guy's safety. Like, Thor and Hulk are just dumbasses. Like, especially when Loki went back to the past to bring a dinosaur into the modern day to distract the Avengers, Thor thought, oh, it was just some welcoming gift and not a threat. Like, Thor, are you stupid? Voice crack, I'm sorry. But anyway, when they get to Santa Claus's house, they decide to take a break and have some hot chocolate instead of just looking for him because he could potentially be in danger. It's like, do you know what Loki can do with those powers? Like, you guys are dumbasses. Iron Man was the only one who was looking around, but he was more checking for security cameras because he didn't believe in Santa Claus, because he wrote a note a while back about how he didn't believe in Santa, and, you know, it was to prove he wasn't real, and, you know, it was undelivered, so yeah, that's what he believed at the time. He was pretty much, Iron Man's acting all childish about it. I'm sorry, I'm losing my voice right here. The final battle is whatever. Loki gets Santa's powers for a few minutes in the final battle. He ends up losing in the end. Santa gets his powers back, happy ending, everyone gets a gift. And it ends with Groot turning into a big Christmas tree and Hulk singing at the end. And everyone delivers presents. I give this movie a 1 out of 10. The only thing I liked about it was a few jokes and the interactions with Rocket and Groot. Despite their side story being filler, I was entertained by it. If this film was just about Rocket and Groot, I wouldn't have minded. But the rest of it is just awful. 1 out of 10 at best. Thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you guys next time when I review Hulk Where Monsters Dwell, which is in the same continuity as the Disney Marvel Universe. So I know it's gonna suck. Hopefully it won't be as bad as this garbage movie.